So once we have funded our wallets or wallet, we can come over to PancakeSwap for Binance Smart Chain, or I recommend Jupiter, jupe.ag for Solana trading. Simply connect your wallet, select MetaMask. You'll have to put in your password and hit connect. Select next, and you'll be able to trade. So for this video, I'm just sticking to the swaps for more advanced features to have to fully utilize these DEXs and everything involved with DeFi. Make sure to check out the Ultimate DeFi course, but for the sake of this video, I'm going to keep it very simple. So if you wanted to swap from BNB to Cake, for instance, you could go 0.01 or whatever the amount that you want to do is. The cool thing with Binance Smart Chain is the swaps are very, very easy. So slippage tolerance, we can see it set up at way over 6%. Typically 1% is more than sufficient. You can adjust that if you want. Simply come down to the slippage tolerance and do 1%. So you can see mine was a little bit higher, but 1% is usually fine. So if you want to do $6 or $5, whatever, typically we're swapping hundreds or thousands of dollars depending on your portfolio size. The day trades really don't really have a whole lot of restrictions on size. We can see the estimated fee is about 33 cents. If you need to verify anything else, of course, always verify the information. I'm going through fairly quickly for the sake of time, but I'm very confident with this. So if you want, also, you can add Cake to the wallet. Simply come in, add the token, and then done. You can see the confirmation came through. The Cake is in our wallet, and we have added. We can add the Cake to our wallet. If you don't see the token, you simply have to come back and add it. And then to swap back, it's the exact same thing. Just come from Cake to BNB, hit swap, confirm the slippage, your price, everything else. Proceed to the wallet. Hit the max. Well, you don't have to hit the max. You can set a custom spending cap if you want, the maximum allowable, and then hit next. Approve. And that's it. Well, permitting Cake. Sign. This is the first time trading that. You'll have to approve the token first. Once it's approved, then you can confirm. Just like that, we're done. So as always, make sure to disconnect your wallet when you're done the swap. And that's it. Wait for the target point, wait for the update, make adjustments. So we also have Jupiter. So you can, I use Solflare. You can stick to the MetaMask extension if you prefer, but just my personal preference, I do use Solflare. So you can simply connect if you want to do, say $10 worth of USD or whatever. You can come in, simply quickly swap. Same thing, watch your transaction, verify that your fees are obviously very small, 0.001 SOL. Make sure there's nothing fishy and approve. And that's it. So there are much more advanced features, perps, bridging, limit order, dollar cost averaging, et cetera, value adding. Value averaging, absolutely dive through it if you want. But for the most part, this is all we need to do. Just a very quick swap. We get in, we want to manage our risk, of course, and always disconnect our wallet when we're done. So you can come in, you can also lock the wallet, right? So simply come in, come to the bottom, lock MetaMask. All said and done, quick and easy and secure. So I haven't personally had any issues ever. Have a good antivirus, anti-spyware installed on your device that you are using to trade with. Make sure that you're not sharing your private keys publicly or storing them on the cloud, and you should be fine. So, hopefully, this video helps. Of course, we do have the weekly live calls if you do have any other questions. But for the most part, it's pretty straightforward. Once you do it a few times, it becomes very comfortable. I guess the one thing, if you do have issues with finding the contract address, you can simply come to coingecko.com. So, this is where you can search for the coin itself, say Arrow was one that we've traded in the past. So this is base layer two. If you want to add, like we showed how to add base, for instance. So you simply come down here and you can find the contract address under info and copy and paste that or verify it. So with these, I do post the contract address with the trade setup so you can easily verify that you have the correct one. So that's it for this video. Hope it helps. Looking forward to see you on the inside. Bye for now.